Hello friends, in this video we will see the differences between OPC and PPC. So let's start. The long form of OPC is ordinary Portland cement and the long form of PPC is Portland pozzolana cement. The ISI mark on ordinary Portland cement bag is black in color, whereas the ISI mark on Portland pozzolana cement bag is red in color. Manufacturing process. The raw materials used to manufacture OPC are calcareous materials containing limestone, that is 60-70%, argillaceous materials containing silica 17-25%, alumina 3-8%, and oxides of iron 0.5-6%, gypsum, magnesia, sulfur trioxide, potash or soda 0.5-1.3%. All these materials are mixed in a fixed proportion and heated in kilns to form clinkers, which are then grinded to required fineness to obtain ordinary Portland cement. Whereas the raw materials used to manufacture PPC are OPC cement clinkers 75-77%, gypsum 3-5%, and pozzolanic material 10-25%, which can be fly ash, rice husk ash, volcanic tuffs, pumicites, clay and shell. All these materials are mixed and grinded to obtain the Portland pozzolana cement. Grades. As per the classification of Bureau of Indian Standards, OPC is available in 33 grade, 43 grade and 53 grade. Whereas, as per Bureau of Indian Standards, PPC is available in 1 grade and its strength matches the strength of 33 grade OPC after curing. IS codes. IS code used for OPC 33 grade cement is IS 269. For 43 grade cement, IS 8112 is used. And for 53 grade cement, IS 12269 is used. Whereas the IS code used for PPC is IS 1489 Part 1 and 2, 1991. Strength. In 3 days, OPC achieves a compressive strength of 35 Newton per mm square. Whereas, in 3 days, PPC achieves a compressive strength of 29 Newton per mm square. In 7 days, OPC achieves a compressive strength of 43.5 Newton per mm square. Whereas, in 7 days, PPC achieves a compressive strength of 39 Newton per mm square. In 28 days, OPC achieves a compressive strength of 55 Newton per mm square. Whereas, in 28 days, PPC achieves a compressive strength of 56.5 Newton per mm square. Initial strength of ordinary Portland cement is higher than Portland pozzolana cement, whereas the long-term strength of Portland pozzolana cement is higher than that of ordinary Portland cement. So it's pretty clear now, if you need high strength at initial stage, then go for OPC. Durability. The durability of concrete made using OPC cement is less than that of concrete made using PPC cement, whereas the durability of concrete made using PPC is higher than OPC, which means the structure made up of PPC will last longer. Workability. Workability means how easily it can flow on the surface. The concrete made using OPC cement has a lower workability, whereas the concrete made using PPC cement has a higher workability. Permeability. Permeability is the quality of any substance to measure how much liquid or water can pass through them. Due to the absence of pozzolanic materials, ordinary Portland cement is highly permeable to the water. On the other hand, Portland pozzolana cement is less permeable. Hence, it is suitable for a structure such as bridge piers or a foundation where the waterproof structure is recommended. Heat of hydration. Heat of hydration is the heat generated when water and cement react. In case of OPC, hydration process takes less time for completion and it produces more heat than PPC. Please note, if cement produces more heat in less time, then it cannot be used for mass concreting, as it may generate cracks in structure. Whereas in case of PPC, hydration process takes longer time and produces less heat during the hydration process. Hence, it is ideal for mass concreting. Setting time. The initial setting time of OPC and PPC is same and it is 30 minutes. Whereas, the final setting time of OPC is 280 minutes, that is 11.67 days. Its setting time is less than PPC, so it is recommended in projects where props are to be removed early. On the other hand, the final setting time of PPC is 600 minutes, that is 25 days. PPC cement prolongs the setting time of concrete, hence it helps in better finishing of concrete. Fineness. The fineness of OPC is at least 225 square meter per kg, which is lower than PPC, hence it is easy to handle. Whereas the fineness of PPC is at least 300 square meter per kg, which is higher than OPC. Hence it is difficult to handle, but it is not a major thing. Resistance to attack against chemicals. In case of OPC, resistance to attack against sulfates, alkalis, chlorides and chemicals is lower as compared to PPC. Whereas PPC has a more resistance towards the attack of sulfates, alkalis, chlorides and chemicals as compared to OPC. Curing time. OPC requires a minimum curing period of 7 days, whereas PPC requires a minimum curing period of 10 days. When OPC is exposed to hot and dry weather condition, the minimum curing period required shall not be less than 10 days. Whereas when PPC is exposed to hot and dry weather condition, the minimum curing period required shall not be less than 14 days. Here you can see the curing period of OPC is less than PPC. Hence the curing cost reduces. And that's why OPC is recommended where curing costs are prohibitive. Environmental impact. During the manufacturing process of OPC, large amount of CO2 emits. Whereas PPC contains 10 to 25% pozzolanic material. Hence it emits less CO2 during manufacturing process. Here, PPC is called as environment friendly as it utilizes byproducts of thermal station. Thus, it reduces environmental problems. Cost. The cost of OPC is around 300 rupees per bag, which is slightly more expensive than PPC. Whereas in case of PPC, the expensive clinker is replaced by pozzolanic material such as fly ash. Hence, the price of PPC is slightly less than OPC. Generally, there is a price difference of 5 rupees. But this slight lesser price creates a considerable difference in overall cost of building and impact on environment. Uses. OPC is the most commonly used cement in construction. Higher grade like grade 53 is not recommended to be used for plastering as it is known to develop shrinkage cracks due to its high strength. OPC is also not used in masonry as mortar strength in initial period is not that critical. OPC can be used for structural members like slabs, columns and beams. Ideal applications for ordinary Portland cement are commercial and industrial complexes, high-rise buildings, roads, bridges, flyovers, heavy defense structures, etc. On the other hand, PPC can be used in all type of construction works like RCC works in residential, commercial and industrial buildings, marine works, mass concrete works like dams, huge foundations, roads, runway, bridges and flyovers, etc. Especially, PPC is used in plastering, masonry, tiling and waterproofing works, as in these works, strength is not the major criteria. Both OPC and PPC are commonly used cements in construction, and both have their pros and cons. Nowadays, PPC is used as a substitute of ordinary Portland cement. Since PPC contains pozzolanic materials, it helps to enhance the strength of concrete and also fulfills the green building criteria. As a result of this, nowadays, most of the OPC manufacturers are shifting to PPC. I hope you can make a correct choice between OPC and PPC after watching this video. So friends, like this video if you learned something and be sure to share it with someone who might benefit from it. You can mention your views in comment section. Subscribe to Engineering Motive for more such videos and turn on that notification bell so that you won't miss the new video. Finally, thanks for watching.